Welcome to another Arkansas Lawman Survival. I just bedded me a trap right here. I'm going to make what is called a T-bone set. And we take our stake driver over here. Kind of like we're going to make a dirt hole. We're going to shove his T-bone kind of camouflage my trap pattern there. Put a guide stick right there. Gonna put us a little bit of food right here in this hole. Now it has to be covered from the air. We'll put a little bit right here too. But we want to make sure we don't get it on the trap. Now I'm going to take me a cotton ball. And I'm going to get me some lure. This is some homemade lure I made up. And we're going to stuff it right in that hole right. And I want to set this for a fox, so I'm not putting coyote urine. Fox, cat, or coyote, either one. But you see these stickers? They don't like stepping on them no more than we do. The coyotes and bobcats and stuff. I'm just going to kind of flatten that out right there. I'm going to take and smooth that out where I got my trap. Just like that. Put my guide stick right there. And that is how you make a T-bone set. We'll see what we have here in the morning. Now this is the campfire set. Huh? I'm talking to the computer. I have caught a lot of canines at this set. I usually use liquid smoke, but I forgot it at the house. But you know, people come out and they eat, they throw food in their campfires when they're done. Them old foxes will come out of a night and eat the food, or the coyotes. And I have had a lot of success digging out my trap bed in these sets here. We're going to go ahead and punch a hole for our trap stake. I'm using cable stakes, Berkshire cable stakes. Now this 1.5 trap will hold coyote. I've caught them in it many times in a fox set. It's not a preferred coyote trap, but it will hold them. I've actually caught one in a little number one. What we're going to do, start our stake down in here. Make sure it's going straight.
Grounded that a little bit more.
I think that'll hold.
Yeah, did your bed too?
I did.
Oh, well, shallow bed.
Mm-hmm. I could dig it out a little bit more.
I forget I do a trench set, mainly. You want some liquid smoke?
Yes, you got any?
Mm-hmm. Come on, man.
I just talking about liquid smoke. That's one of my favorite things to add to these campfire sets.
Give me credit. I'm a fox trapper. Come on, man.
Got a trap set. I'm gonna take, I'm gonna bait it where it don't move. Cover a chain too. We're gonna fill this hole in here. And we don't want this trap to move. We don't want it to wobble. But we're gonna put a dirt hole right here in between these rocks. I got me some peat moss. It got a little bit wet. It's freshly rained, so it don't really matter anyway. We're gonna take our loose dirt, sit back on top. A lot of people say, oh, you don't wear gloves. That critter is gonna know you've been here, no matter if you wear gloves or not. I've had first night catches without wearing gloves.
Just depends if your bait's good enough and strong enough to keep them there and you're attractive. That's all that matters.
And we're going to take
this rock right here.
Oh. Yeah, just a little dab on that rock right there. And we're going to put us a little bit of guidance in. You want to go ahead and set yours, son?
I'm going to wait until I find a little bit cattier place. I'm going to go cat.
I'm going to go ahead and put some bait in there, which I'm using pink salmon.
This works for about everything.
Now, we don't want that really right there on the trap bed. Now, we're going to take our cotton ball.
Or another gad stick.
Yeah. And we're going to put our cotton ball right here. And then we're going to put another cotton ball where the bait was with another lure. And that's how you make the campfire set. So there's two sets I've showed you today. Beautiful sunset there, ain't it? Waiting on Beaver Man to get his bobcat set on. And then I'm sitting for a coyote right here. Right here at a crossroads. So if he's coming down this way, he's got a good way to see my backing right there. Bone, they're not going to be scared of. It's natural. They chew on it since there's a pup. And see, the other road goes this way. So I'm right here at a crossroads. Ideal spot. While he's doing that, I'm getting my trap bed dug. Then he'll probably come get some bait. I'm gonna drizzle some juice on there. put some bait right there in that hole. This little lure right there. Get it in there good. Get it in there good. Gonna put a little bit of Billy Doris's buffalo wall on there. Rest in peace, Billy. Great lure maker, friend. Okay. I'm gonna hammer in my punch in my hole for my steak. My guide hole. Pilot hole. Should straighten that out a little bit, but that'd be all right. I reused my disposable steaks. It's not wanting to catch right. Nope. Slipped off again. This is his steak driver. He's got mine at his boss's place. It's a little bit wider than I'm used to it. He already caught a nice cat this year. That's rock right there. This way. You'll make sure that steak is caught. It ain't going nowhere. I have fun getting that one up. Because when it rains, sometimes it'll soften that ground back up. You want to make sure you got it good. Let's see. carry that chain. We'll pack this old clay dirt around it. That way it don't wiggle. Try to get that dog down, pinned down just a little bit more. Take some of these leaves. We're going to try to blend this set in. Get rid of some of this dirt. You don't want nothing in there to clog the trap pan.
What flowers?
We're just gonna take kind of camouflage your set here. Did you?
Oh.
I put up a flag just in case. Maybe you'll see it come to one of ours. But that I used that cotton ball right there for a flag kind of blowing in the wind. Where the track, it won't shy a coyote, y'all. But here is the finished set. Right here. Thanks for watching this edition of Arkansas Wild Man Survival and the Beaver Man. God bless you, and thanks for watching.